there's a group of people over there. They issue threats, and they call them laws. And they issue demands for money, and they call it taxes. And if you disobey, they send men with guns to hurt you. Now, are you really incapable of distinguishing between yourself and them? One of the biggest giveaways that the belief in government is a complete blind faith religious belief is the way people respond. One very easy line of questioning is, can you give somebody else a right that you don't have? And everybody says, well, no, of course not. Well, how about you and your buddy? Can the two of you give someone else a right that neither of you had? Well, no. And it only takes a couple more questions to get to, well, how did Congress get rights that you don't have? They get emotional and they get angry or they get defensive or they run away. They didn't come to this belief through reasoning and evidence and logic. They came there by having a blind faith belief smashed into their heads starting before they could even talk. It's just something they were taught to believe, that there's this thing called authority and that it's allowed to do things that human beings aren't and that people have an obligation to obey it, to the point where, yeah, it's some people, they weren't gods or anything, some people wrote down a thing on paper and then they called it legislation and they did certain rituals and then people go around saying, well, this is law. Most people literally feel physical discomfort and fear at the thought of disobeying anyone in authority. Most people can't say, no, I'm not going to do that, because it goes against their years and years of programming and indoctrination that trains them to think, if you do as you're told, you're good. If you don't, you're bad. And that's the message of school, and that message gets pounded in people's heads. Students are taught over and over and over and over again every stinking day they're in school that the measure of your virtue is how well you obey authority. The whole approval-disapproval thing. The one thing you learn in school is if you do as you're told, you get approval and reward. And if you don't do as you're told, you get disdain and condemnation. They'll make sure everybody knows you're a bad person because you didn't do as you were told. The belief in authority leads everybody, good people, bad people, everything in between, to advocate and do things they wouldn't otherwise do, bad things they wouldn't otherwise do, including cops, because the cops really and truly believe that they have the right to do things that I don't have the right to do and you don't have the right to do. The only reason most of them do what they do is because they believe in authority and they really believe that legislation gives them an exemption from morality. So that when they do something and someone says, hey, what you're doing is bad, hey, I don't make the law, I just enforce it. I'm not responsible for my actions, I'm just a tool of some weird thing somewhere else called government. You can't blame me for what I am personally doing because I'm not really doing it. As loony as that is, that's what most of them will say. Whenever somebody says, hey, what you're doing is wrong, it's not okay to, you know, it's not okay to lock people up for smoking marijuana, it's not okay, you know, all the ways in which, quote unquote, law enforcement initiates violence against nonviolent people. And if you bring that up to them, they literally talk as if they didn't do it. The only reason they do that is because they were taught the lie of authority and government and law along with everyone else, and then they were told, you're just a tool of the thing called law, and that makes it so you have rights that other people don't have. So you don't have to feel bad about physically assaulting nonviolent people because the law says it's okay. It really is just permission to ignore your conscience by saying you have rights that other people don't. You know, you don't have the right to tell other people what habit to have on your own. You don't have the right to go and extort people on your own. But once you are law enforcement, then not only is it okay, it's noble and great to go around robbing people and bossing them around. That is the biggest danger of the belief in authority. It tricks good people into condoning or doing really nasty, horrible, violent things because they think, well, this is okay if government and authority does it.
They are raised by their parents, by the school, by the government, by the culture, by all the authoritarian messages built into everything, to think that obedience is a virtue. And when you raise the culture to think that, and you get one nasty psycho at the top who says, hey, go do bad stuff, people say, well, I have to follow orders. I have to obey the law. I have to do as I'm told, because that's a virtue. And then good people march off and do evil stuff. I'm not scared of the Maos and the Stalins and the Hitlers. I'm scared of the thousands or millions of people that hallucinate them to be authority and so do their bidding and pay for their empires and carry out their orders. I don't care if there's one loony with a stupid mustache. He is not a threat if the people do not believe in authority. Some people assume that, well, you must trust everybody if you don't want government. That's not at all true. I don't nearly trust everybody, but if I don't trust people to run their own lives, why on earth would I trust them to be in a position of power where they can forcibly run other people's lives?
Really what it boils down to is saying, I don't trust people. People are untrustworthy and unpredictable. So my solution is to take some of those people, some of the most untrustworthy around, give them permission to violently control us all, and that will protect us from the untrustworthiness of mankind. Okay, you're so scared of the average man out there and so thankful for government. Let me ask you, who has taken more of your money under threat of force? Private people threatening you or agents of authority threatening you? How many murders are committed by private people compared to how many are committed by people acting on behalf of authority? It's not even close. The number of murders committed in the name of law enforcement and government and authority completely dwarfs private murder. Even governments killing the people of other countries is small compared to them killing their own people. In the last 100 years, over 270 million human beings killed by their own governments, not counting war. That first